The story you're about to hear is true. Mike was a senior in high school. Like most other guys his age, he wanted to be successful, play ball, and have a good time.
We get it almost every night. And when that moon gets big and bright, it's supernatural delight. Every border was dancing in the moonlight.
The game that afternoon was a tough game. Jeff didn't pitch that well. In the fifth inning,
the coach sent me in to relieve Jeff. When the game was over, I heard Coach call my name. Coach told me the Met Scout wanted to speak to me. I hustled over to Jeff and the Scout, and I thanked him for coming from New York to watch us lose, and he simply said,
"Good effort, son. I'd like to come back and watch you pitch a game."
Jeff got face-to-face with the New York Mets despite losing the game, then got sweet-talked by the New York Mets, and to top it off, he wanted to come back and watch me pitch a game. We had some celebrating to do. Man, I mean, we were flying. I was riding home with Teddy, sitting in the front seat, and we were flying, racing down the road, not a care in the world. Oh. Telephone poles look like a picket fence. No seatbelt. I looked across at the speedometer, and the needle was between 90 and 100 miles per hour. All of a sudden, he lost control of the car. He tries to downshift, the gears lock. He hits the brakes lock, and we begin to skid. I will never forget the screeching sound of those tires trying to stop that car. We were just holding on, trying to survive the ride. I pulled my legs out from under the dashboard and placed them on top of the dashboard, kind of coiling into a ball. Out in front of me, I saw a pile of dirt and a big black shadow. I coiled as tight as I can get, sort of trying to make sure nothing would get torn off. I mean, I remember clenching my teeth like a vice grip. You would have needed a crowbar to pry my teeth apart. Then all of a sudden, we hit the pile of dirt, flipping us into the big black shadow, and it felt like my face exploded. Then all of a sudden I was in a state of complete peace, like my body shifted into neutral. We hit the pile of dirt in front of the bulldozer, flipping us into the plow head on at full speed. Lucky me, I stayed in one piece, falling into a coma from the impact of the car hitting the bulldozer and my head slamming against the ceiling of the car when it flipped. Yeah, I know what you're thinking. It serves those fools right, drinking and driving. But you have to remember, we were kids. Nothing like this is ever gonna happen to us.
Or so we thought.
The ambulance took Mike to the hospital where he laid in a coma for 6 weeks. For 6 weeks, his thoughts drifted like changing channels. He could hear sounds, but he couldn't wake up to tell his mom and dad that he was okay. Mike was lucky. When he did wake up from the coma, he endured many months of painful physical therapy, and he did survive. Not everyone is so lucky. Whatever you do, if you drive, don't drink. And if you drink, take drugs or text, don't drive.